everyone. I'm John Hanson, and this is WGN Radio's Your Hometown. And today we are in the northern suburb of Libertyville. There is so much to do here. We're going to explore a lot of culture, visit a museum. I know we're going to be fed well along the way too. But I've just got to say, maybe it's because it's 70 degrees and spring on the day we visited Libertyville, but I'm loving it here. And it's got an awesome downtown. And that's where we're going to start, just by shopping around. Walking around downtown, you see so many businesses on Milwaukee Avenue. There's Pizzeria DeVille. Ooh, it's just such great pizza. O'Toole's is right next door. That's a great place to get a good pint and maybe a bite. And speaking of good pints, there's Mickey Finn's. That's just a few steps away. There's Marigold's Gift Shop with great shopping. You got Main Street Social. Plus, you got places to buy chocolate. There's boutique shops for clothing, places to get good food for your dog, places to watch a comedy show, even companies downtown that are focused on fitness. There's 847 Running Company, and of course, there's Black Cat Yoga. There's an old post office downtown. You got the train station. Libertyville, that downtown area is so cool. It just has it all, including, of course, great coffee shops. There's Conscious Cup Coffee Roasters. There's Birdie's Coffee Shop right next to the Metro stop. And also, just a few steps away, you're getting the theme here, I was really impressed with Hansa Coffee Roasters. It's named after a famous German trade route and organization. It's got great coffee. It also seems like a great place just to sit, relax, watch the trains go by, get some work done. Just awesome coffee places up and down the downtown area. Just a bit south of downtown is Bagels by the Book. They've got an incredible new mural. That's another great place to sit, relax, have a bite, and hang out, and enjoy the friendly atmosphere. Downtown's also got parks. It's got spaces to spread out. It's got free parking for a couple hours. You don't see that a lot in some downtowns in the suburbs. And also all of those great businesses. Everything just a short walk away. And just a little bit north of downtown is the Adler Arts Center, a serene and calming place to take in some beauty, nature, and incredible art.
The Adler Center is committed to preserve, educate, and bring the arts to the Libertyville community as well as all of Lake County and, you know, North Chicago suburbs. So David Adler was an architect, and this was his home. It was his estate back in the early, 1900s. So 1918, he bought the land, the house, and really just used it as his laboratory for his commission. So he's pretty well known for a lot of buildings and houses on, along the North Shore. There's something for everybody. So we have, our biggest program is our individual music instruction. So we offer music lessons in all different types of instruments. We also have art classes. Our biggest art program right now is our ceramic program. And we also do group Earth Day events. We do all kinds of things. Our big initiative right now is our woods. So it's called the Woods at the Adler Center. We've been trying to get rid of the buckthorn, create spaces for people to enjoy nature and bring art to those nature areas.
With spring here and warmer temperatures on the way, Libertyville has no shortage of places to grab some ice cream. Downtown, again, there's Sweet Home Gelato, which, oh, it just looks so good. And just a few blocks away is the Dairy Dream Drive-In, which is home to 28 soft serve flavors. And just up the way is Lee Famous Donuts, which is such a great place to get some homemade fresh pastries and treats. Of course, donuts too. And one of the real hidden treats in Libertyville is the Dunn Museum. It's named after Bess Bauer Dunn, one of the first women in motion pictures, was also a clerk in the probate office in Lake County. An extraordinary woman and a great museum. You kind of learn chronologically about the history of what used to be in Lake County, how its history developed, and why it's an important place in our area's history.
The Bess Bauer Dunn Museum is a great museum, and it helps you walk through the history of Lake County all the way from dinosaurs to today. So the museum is laid out chronologically, starting with prehistory. Welcoming all of our guests is the world's only fully fleshed out replica of a Dryptosaurus, which is a dinosaur that's a relative of the T-Rex. And then you go into early paleo times with fossils of mammoths and saber-tooths, et cetera. Move into when the land was used only by American Indians, into the early settlement time. We talk about the Civil War, which seems a little odd. There were no battles in Illinois. Why would we talk about the Civil War? A full 25% or more of the able-bodied men in Lake County left. We have a series of temporary exhibits that are here, and our exhibit that's coming up starting in the middle of April is Bill Sienkiewicz, and he is best known for over 40 years reimagining both the comic and graphic illustration field.
We also had to check out O'Reilly's Furniture and Amish Gallery. They've been around since 1977, and they specialize in custom dining sets, entertainment centers, sofas, sectionals, and so much more, all made in America. And before leaving town, I had to get refueled at McDonald's. They're celebrating 1 year of their crispy chicken sandwich, tender, juicy white meat. I got traditional flavor. Our producer, Rook, he wanted spicy. Of course, great service as always. Drive-thru or if you're dining in. They got great food, as you all know. And the McDonald's we stopped in, another great locally owned and operated spot that helps the community with McTeacher's Nights. They have scholarships for students in the community, and they put a real value on making their experience great for their employees. Well, Libertyville, it was a great day to stop on by. The weather was warm when we were there that day, which you never know what you get in spring, and it just felt so nice walking around and being part of a great hometown. So everyone in the area, whether you've been there or not, stop on by and visit. That's it for your hometown. Till next time, I'm John Hansen, and let us know where we should visit next time on WGN.